both Caprivi Strip and Caprivi Zipfel were like the port of Walvis Bay, which is 30 kilometers from Swakopmund. It was not part of the colony. In fact, the port of Walvis Bay only came to this country, was incorporated in this country, one, on a Security Council resolution that the port should be negotiated with South Africa. It was negotiated and it took 4 years for it to be incorporated in Namibia. That you must know. It was a German sphere of influence, and I wish people could read and understand what is a sphere of influence. It was not part of the German policy zone. The policy zone had three areas. One, Mululani Gate. Two, Oshivelo Gate. Three, Veda. That's what constituted the German colony
in Southwest Africa.
Ovamboland only became part of the German colony in 1926, after the First World War, with the permission of the League of Nations. That's why Ovamboland was regarded as part of Southern Angola. It was not part of Southwest Africa. The last area that was taken by the German before the First World War was called Hererolandi. That is the area. Now, all these things are recorded. All what we need to do is, let's get back to the books and find out. Now, I have no problem in someone trying to make this place as part of Namibia. I have no problem, but there must be proper formal channels for this place to be taken, so that tomorrow nobody will stand up and say, but this was not part of your country. That argument is likely to arise. The same thing applies in Botswana. Botswana is now sitting in Kasane. They are not supposed to be there. Chobe.
Why?
Because it was not part of the protectorate. Kalagadi. It's not part of the protectorate. Hansi, it's not part of the protectorate. Those three areas, they were not part of Botswanaland protectorate. But we want to know, how did Botswana acquire those areas? We know that the English and the Tswanas have had this smooth relationship for a very long time. But the English have no right to give away a country.
So where did they belong by that time?
It was part of Sibitwane country. It was part of Makololo country. It was part of Zambesia. It was part of Moha.
Okay.
Yes. The same British even issued British orders in council. First, the 27th of June, 1890. The second one, 30th of June, 1890. All these are British orders in council in favor of Zambesia, in favor of Makololo country, in favor of Sikeleto country, in favor of Sibitwane country. So these two countries, Namibia and Botswana, they are trying to hide the identity of Zambesia. And we are saying, no, let's talk about this. Because where is the difference between us saying, no, let's look at this. Because if that was the case, then it's hypocrisy. Because Namibia rejected South Africa to rule Namibia for a very long time. South Africa ruled this country for over 70 years. Why didn't they say no? Because you were in charge of this, we leave it at that. We are following in the footsteps of the liberators, such as the former president and others. We are following, we are asking questions, we are not asking for war.
Mr. Siambango, let's look back now on your movement so far. How far have you engaged with the former colonizers of the Southwest Africa as far as the Zambezia country is
concerned? We have written letters to His Excellency President Hage Geingob, where we said this new boundary between Botswana and Namibia to us is null and void. We have never received a single response. We wrote to Tate Pohamba, President Pohamba, We wrote letters. We wrote letters to President Kama. We wrote letters to President, former President of Zimbabwe, Robert Mugabe, Gabriel Mugabe. We have written letters to President Edgar Lungu to inform them. We even gave copies to the Queen of England. We even gave copies to the Prime Minister. We even gave copies to Barack Obama, the President of the USA. We even gave copies to the Chancellor of Germany. We've done that. But nobody has come back to us. Not even to acknowledge. Because what we are telling is the truth, nothing the truth. We should not... If people want to take this place, let the people express their views. Yes, people are saying Muyongo is the worst man you can... When Mr. Muyongo says Caprivi is not part of Southwest Africa, he is telling the truth. I'm not a member of his party, but I can vouch that on that one he's telling the truth. Because I can pick up a textbook and say, here it is. Okay? So we've tried to engage everybody. And then here, we are trying to disseminate information relative to this country. There were five countries in Southern Africa, Mr. Lumanesi. Five. One, South Africa. Two, Bechuanaland. Three, German Protectorate of Southwest Africa. In fact, before it became German Protectorate of Southwest Africa, it was called Greater Namaqualand and Damaraland. Four, Portuguese East Africa, which is Mozambique. Five, Zambezia. What has happened to Zambezia? That's our question. So people can say whatever they want, but this is a historical fact. Let's talk about it. The business of trying to fight each other, whatever. Let's look at the facts. Let's look at the facts. And you know what? Today I'm saying this. Tomorrow somebody is coming to say, because they say no case gets septic. In other tribes they say umula anduta ubola. In other words, no case can get septic. What we are talking about here is, let's look at this. What instrument was applied for this place to be taken over as part of? I can tell you, it was the South African wish. The South African wish were trying to stop the liberation movements to move across the Zambezi. That's why they came, even set up camp at Impalila Island. Can you imagine Impalila Island and the Kasani belonging to two different countries? What kind of madness is this? That's one country. That plateau that you see when you are in Ngoma, you see that plateau there.